being for the Democrats, we need to twist and meld and work. We are fighting against an enemy, the Republicans, with machine guns, and we can't bring a knife to it. Simply facts and the laws are not going to protect us right now.
Welcome back. If it wasn't obvious before that all this impeachment nonsense is really just about avoiding a loss in 2020, Donnie Deucebag just gave it away right there. It's really all about their fear that Trump is going to defeat Democrats in the upcoming election. What the hell is this demagogue even talking about? Here's a fact. The Democrats and their media have been pushing for impeachment from the very moment that Trump took office.
A bombshell.
Today is a turning point. Today was historically bad for President Trump.
Today was a turning point.
A turning point.
We're at a turning point here.
The beginning of the end for the Trump presidency.
We have another bombshell.
Mike Pence might have to assume the office of the presidency.
Rumblings of the word impeachment.
Breaking news.
Another bombshell out of the White House.
I believe this is the beginning of the end.
I do too.
It's really the beginning of the end.
He may be feeling the walls closing in on him.
All the walls closing in on him.
The walls closing in on him.
Breaking news, a new bombshell.
One astrologer says this means the beginning of the end for President Donald Trump.
Trump will resign.
Trump is going to resign.
Is this the tipping point? I know we've said it over and over.
You think this is a tipping point?
And over and over.
This is a tipping point.
And over and over.
We'll get right back to this MSNBC meltdown, but first, let me take a quick moment to thank this episode's sponsor, PatrioticLegacy.com. PatrioticLegacy.com was nice enough to send me over one of these units so I could give you an honest review. I love this tactical flashlight. It's got everything you would ever need. 6 overall lighting functions, escape features like the window hammer and the seatbelt cutter, solar charging so you don't need batteries, a power bank for charging your phone and other devices, and a removable compass with access to a personal safety alarm. Patriot Legacy supports veterans and YouTubers like yours truly. So head on over there and make sure to use the promo code DRONE20 to get 20% off your purchase. Thank you. That tells me that he's broken no laws and the system is working as it's supposed to. Every single move that Trump makes is scrutinized and criticized. So if he had actually broken a law or done something that warranted impeachment, there would be conclusive proof of it. And for that matter, why would he do anything like that knowing that there's a giant microscope that's constantly on him? In regards to this most recent impeachment attempt, we actually have very little in the way of hard facts and lots of speculation. Look, even if he did what they said, we already know that the Obama administration did the exact same thing and even bragged about it. But they of course think that it's different when they do it, and they're going to enforce that double standard for as long as they can.
We need to twist and meld and work. We are fighting against an enemy, the Republicans, with machine guns, and we can't bring a knife to it. And I'm not saying do anything dishonest, but...
Did you catch that? The Republicans are the enemy, and we, the media, have to fight them. Just imagine that Sean Hannity was speaking in these terms about Democrats. Helter Skelter would be on every single night for a week, whining about violent right-wingers dividing the country and inciting hatred with extremist rhetoric. But no, there's none of that because MSNBC is their ideological partner. This isn't new territory for Douche either. He actually has a long history of predicting and encouraging uprisings.
We are at war. It is time for the Democrats to wake up. We are playing against cheaters and liars or stealers. You own it. You own the blood that happens. And we should be very frightened. It's not just saying, you know, or authoritarian tendencies. I believe this man is capable of horrific, horrific deeds. And I'm not saying specifically what that is. If he gets voted out of office, he will say it was fake. He will say the polls were rigged. He will tell his people to take to the streets. Whatever in a movie you think this guy is capable of doing to create a civil war, he will do. I know that's, I'm not speaking in hyperbole.
It's clear that they don't have much confidence for 2020, and they're doing what they do best, fear-mongering.
President clearly violated his oath of office, and what he did, it was easily proven. It's been proven over the past several weeks. He committed bribery. He got caught red-handed. I think Democrats need to expand this. They need to bring in all of the high crimes and all of the misdemeanors that this president has committed and lay it bare, not only for the American people now, but for history, for future generations.
Wow, you would think that Joe Scarborough is an operative for the DNC. That little speech that he just gave right there sounded like he was trying out for Schiff's job. Let's take a quick look at everything he just regurgitated. 1. The president clearly violated his oath of office. How exactly did he do that? In all of your bloviating, you never specifically say. They never do. They're always as vague as they can possibly be. 2. It's been proven. It's been proven over the past several weeks he committed bribery. If the investigations were a requirement for the aid, which we now know they never were, they got the aid and their Javelin missiles. And we're gonna call that bribery, then wasn't it bribery when Biden withheld aid from Ukraine unless they fired the prosecutor that was investigating the corrupt energy company that Joe Biden's son was inexplicably working for? I know. I know.
It's different when we do it.
3. I think Democrats need to expand this. They need to bring in all the high crimes and all the misdemeanors that this president has committed and lay it to bear not only for the American people, but for history, for future generations. Okay, if there really were all these high crimes and misdemeanors, why haven't they presented them yet? Why hasn't Joe Scarborough listed a single one in his rambling screed? Because this is all kabuki theater with no real substance.
And one of the things that I'm going to read you, this isn't from your book, this is actually from the New York Times, and it's a piece called Donald Trump Meet Your Precursor. Most significantly, both men, this is Trump and Andrew Johnson, right, made an undisguised championship of white supremacy. You go, whenever I have an historian on, I like the historian to remind the country, these two parties, the Republicans and the Democrats, were exactly reversed.
Exactly.
At that time.
Exactly. The anti-slavery party was very, very clear. That's what they stood for. And the Democrats were for, you know, small government, and became associated with the white supremacist.
Yeah, absolutely. They were the conservative party. They were reversed, folks.
Wrong.
Isn't it interesting that these people who are clearly obsessed with skin color and race are constantly accusing their political opposition of being obsessed with skin color and race? As a former left-winger, I can attest that what drove me away is this complete lack of self-awareness. As a right-winger and Republican today, I still hold my beliefs that human beings are all pretty much the same, and I don't discriminate based on skin color. All Joy Reid is really doing here is broadly generalizing and demonizing her political opposition because she lacks convincing arguments or good ideas. Another big lie that she perpetuated there is that Democrats and Republicans somehow flipped and now Republicans are pro-slavery and anti-civil rights. It's just not true. As PragerU pointed out, there's actually 3 myths surrounding this bogus claim. 1. In order to be competitive in the South, Republicans started to pander to white racists in the 60s. The truth is, Republicans didn't need to become competitive in the South because they already were. Going all the way back to the 20s when Herbert Hoover won over 40% of the South's popular vote. In 52, Eisenhower won all the important Southern states, and then again in 56. The important point here is that he actually won all these victories after he supported desegregation in schools. Can Joy Reid explain how that fits into her little conspiracy theory? How does supporting desegregation play to racists in the South? It doesn't make any sense. And in fact, Republicans didn't hold a majority of Southern congressional seats until 1994, long after the Civil Rights Act had passed. As Kevin Williamson of National Review points out, quote, "If Southern rednecks ditched the Democrats because of a civil rights law passed in 1964, it's strange that they waited until the late 80s and early 90s to do so." That's all I got for you today, folks. Please hit that like button, share, and subscribe. And while you're at it, go ahead and hit that notification bell so you can be alerted to all my new content. If you'd like to support this channel, you can do so on Patreon, Subscribestar, or just send a donation on PayPal. You can find all the links in the description and the pinned comment. Thank you.